I think this world needs more of it. When I was growing up in high school, I remember what it was like to not be able to be who I am. I remember what it was like to be trapped because people didn't know who I was, because I was afraid to come out to my mom. I was afraid to come out to my dad. I was afraid to come out to my cousins. This fear that we live under is unacceptable. This past June, we received the right to marry from the California State Supreme Court. We're here against Proposition 8. It's unfair, it's wrong. For the first time, we're facing an election where people want to write discrimination into our Constitution. We should be moving forward as a state, forward as a nation.
It would take a right that people have as of May 15th, 2008, and tear it into shreds. They can't even speak it out loud because they know that they have to use fear and confusion to trick people into supporting something so absurd. They use words like defend and protect and preserve as if somehow it's in their hands, when in actuality, it's in all of our hands. Marriage is constantly changing. They want me in their kitchen or in the closet. And I refuse to accept that somehow those were the nostalgic days that we as a society should be aiming for. We should be aiming for a society and a legal system that can agree to give all of its citizens the same basic rights.
As a straight ally, I know that I'm fighting not for my own rights, but for everyone to have the opportunity to have the same rights. The San Diego Union Tribune endorsed the No on 8 campaign and said, like many Californians, they too had changed their minds and that they did not believe marriage rights should be eliminated for anyone. That's huge. We know that the most strategic thing that we can do is not get in fights with the opposition who believes this. Our target is those undecided voters. They need that one-to-one conversation. So I'm really challenging everyone today to have that really difficult conversation with your roommate, with your parents, with your grandmother. This is not just an LGBT issue. If every LGBT member voted no on this proposition, that would not be enough for us to win. We're looking for people to work with us on Election Day because that is the most historic 13 hours of LGBT history. This is going to make or break the history of California.
I was honestly not planning to make a speech tonight, today. But I got an email yesterday that really kind of scared me. It's the tone that the opposition is taking right now is almost apocalyptic. You might notice from my accent that I'm actually not from these parts. I'm from South Africa, and guess what South Africa has? It has gay marriage. And it's had it for the last 3 years, and as far as I know, it still hasn't sunk below the ocean. No volcanoes have popped up, no riots in the streets. But guess what? 10% of South Africa is a lot happier than what they were 4 years ago. And I want to see that same happiness pervade California. I want it to pervade all the states, because I do believe that America is a leader, and this is one of the things that we can make a world of difference for.
No one has come from the-